offensive firepower that we haven't seen since Steve Spurrier's last few years that produced 11 win seasons. And then with the defensive personnel being somewhat up in the air and somewhat a little thin in spots, but trusting the defensive prowess on the coaching staff to get things done and piece things together. So, the offense could be explosive and something that fans want to see. Hey, if they're not going to see a championship season, hey, let's go out there and score some points and make the games fun.
Well, you know what, we know Will Muschamp's resume. It doesn't involve offense. I mean, he's had 6 years as a head coach now, 5 years as a head coach. This is year six. And you go back to his Florida days, and that stigma is still with him. That reputation is still there that, hey, this guy can coach defense with the best of them, but, man, do his offenses stink. And so I think there's a feeling that, hey, especially in the South Carolina fan base, this guy has his quarterback. He has Jake Bentley. He has Deebo Samuel and Hayden Hurst. He has two good running backs in Tyson Williams and Rico Dowdle. This can be the offense that finally goes with a Will Muschamp defense. And I think it's interesting because, again, you're not hearing people say, oh, South Carolina. You're not hearing people here say, we expect an SEC East championship. People here just want to win eight games. Get us to eight wins. But you're right, the excitement for an offense and a defense that a lot of people feel like will be better. Now, how much better is the question? But that's caused excitement, and you're exactly right. That stigma that surrounds Will Muschamp, that national narrative that surrounds Will Muschamp, I think not only do South Carolina fans want to prove it wrong this year, we know Will Muschamp does, but certainly the offense, they know it. They've heard the stuff. Going back to SEC Media Day, they're excited to prove that Will Muschamp can have an offensive team as well.